सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां वाग्मे मनसि प्रतिष्ठिता मनो मे वाचि प्रतिष्ठितं आविरावीर्मेधि वेदस्य माणीस्थः श्रुतं मे मा प्रहासीः अनेनाधीतेन अहोरात्रान् संदधामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवतु तद्वक्तारमवतु अवतु माम् अवतु वक्तारम् ओम शांति 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 ही ओम हिरण्यवर्णां हरिणीं सुवर्णरजतस्रजां चंद्रां हिरण्मयीं लक्ष्मीं जातवेदो महावह तां महावह जातवेदो लक्ष्मीमनपगामिनीं यस्यां हिरण्यं विन्देयं गामश्वं पुरुषानहम्। सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द श्री सूक्तम। सूक्तम मीन्स समथिंग विच इज वेल सेड। सुष्टु उक्तम वी कैन टेक। सो जनरली ए सूक्ता मीन्स we are praising a devata. And why do we praise a devata? Because we have some prayers. So in our tradition there are many suktas addressed to many many devatas. All these specific prayers, because any prayer we address to a particular devata is a specific prayer. We also have general prayers like sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, sarve santu niramayaha, like that, correct? So let everybody be a sukhi. They all let everybody be happy. Let them enjoy. Let no one have any disease. Like this, general prayers also we have. But we have specific prayers, lots of specific prayers. And the specific prayers are generally addressed towards specific devata. So now we have to first understand what do we mean by a devata. Because if you read English books, they may simply translate devata as gods, or sometimes they put a small g. A capital G is God, singular. Then they put small g and write gods or demigod and all that. Now all this translation, I think we can leave it out because it doesn't really convey much. So we have to understand how we look at devata in our tradition, and we can still just use the word devata itself. So devata means we are looking at Ishvara through a particular phenomenon. So for any phenomenon, there is a individual instance of that. Okay, let me use a programming terminology. And also an abstraction is always there, correct? Or the totality. Or you can call it in Sanskritam, there is a vyakti and there is a samashti. The samashti also includes the abstract part of it, or the jati, you can say. So let us take sight. Seeing is a phenomenon. Sight is a phenomenon. Sight is there in human eyes. So in human eyes, sight functions in a particular manner. We have photochromatic vision, they say, correct? We have, we can see colors, and our eyes are actually a lot of all this. Nowadays, we have all these cameras, correct? So many MP and all, they say. 48 MP camera in the mobile. Eyes are supposed to have a lot more MPs than that. So that means the clarity with which it can see is very high. But then even our eyes are not that great. The eyes of an eagle is supposed to have a lot more range and clarity. And eyes of an owl function totally differently. It can see even at night. Like this, sight itself, as a phenomenon, it is there. And the way it is manifest in different beings also is different. But still, sight, we can look at it totally, that there is sight as a phenomenon. And for that, we have a devata. Because the devata only is manifest as sight wherever sight is there. That is our understanding. Wherever the phenomenon of sight is there, there that devata alone is manifest as that individual phenomenon. So in human being also, sight is a particular devata. In owl also, the sight is that devata only. In eagle also, the sight is that devata only. In a cow also, sight is that devata only. Cow's vision is different. It cannot see colors, they say. So wherever there is sight, this devata is manifest. That devata is the samashti, the total, with reference to that particular phenomenon. So we say Aditya Devata is the one for sight. Then vak, speech. Speech also is a phenomenon. Wherever there is speech, Agni Devata is manifest. We say Agni is the devata for vak. So like this, each and every phenomenon you take, some of these things are sentient, some of these things are abstract, correct? So for all these devatas, we can have sukta. And devatas can also be insentient things like nadi. Nadi is a devata for us, river. Vriksha can be a devata. Trees are devatas for us. And even Ratri, there is a Ratri Suktam is there. Even gambling, there is a Suktam for gambling also. Can you imagine? Even that, or even Medha Suktam we already saw, correct? Medha is a ability to hold information and analyze that. A Grantha Dharanam and Smaranam. So you can understand what you read, then you can retain it, and then you can recollect it whenever you want. That is the Medha. Now that itself, that ability itself is looked upon as a devata, because that is a phenomenon which is manifesting in you, correct? So wherever this ability to understand and hold it, and then even recollect it whenever you want, that phenomenon is devata, that is the Medha Devata. And we then can have a prayer to that, saying that you give me that Medha. So like that here, what is the devata? Shri is the devata. Shri Suktam. So this Shri Devata means what? Shri means we understand wealth. In general, we can translate it as wealth. Then, but how do we understand wealth itself? Very important, correct? Because many people think wealth means only money, correct? So they go after money, career, And then they later on they say, no, no, I am burnt out. I don't have any work-life balance. All these problems are there, correct? The wife is not happy. Husband never comes home. All the time working. So, our understanding of wealth also we have to understand. Traditionally, Shri or Lakshmi also is the word we use, correct? Lakshmi is not just one wealth or money. We looked upon Lakshmi or look upon Lakshmi as Ashta Lakshmi. It is very important to understand. So, eight forms of Lakshmi. So, first we have Adi Lakshmi. Adi Lakshmi is wealth in general, who is the source of all wealth and well-being, like that we can take. So Adi Lakshmi, in fact, we have an Ashta Lakshmi temple in Chennai, on the beach. We used to go there as children. We always enjoyed going there because we can also go to the beach and have a good time there. So Adi Lakshmi, then Dhana Lakshmi. Dhanam also is Lakshmi. We don't say that Dhanam is not Lakshmi or Dhanam is not important or money is not important. Understand that. Money is important. If somebody says money is not important, then you can tell them, okay, you give the money to me. Because at least I know how to spend it properly. We have so many things on which we can spend the money on. And I know how to spend it properly. So if you don't want money, you can always give it. No problem. Because money has buying power. So we have to objectively look at everything. Money is useful. Money has buying power. But money can't buy everything also. That also we have to understand objectively. So Dhanam also is Lakshmi, no doubt. Dhana Lakshmi. But you have only Dhanam. Can you eat Dhanam? You have a famine. What will you do? You can't eat your rupee note and survive. Under normal circumstance, a rupee note can get you a lot of food. But if there is a famine, correct? What will you do? Even though you have lots of money, you may not get any food. In fact, in Chennai, in 2015, we had a great flood. Okay. Unbelievable rains. And the waters came up to the second floor. That means around 15-20 feet in many places. People were forced to go to the terrace and stay there. Those who had multi-story building, they all had to move up one floor or a couple of floors. Nobody could go out. For 3 days, people were stuck. They didn't have any food. So even those who had Mercedes car and all was totally in water. Even they did not have any food. They had to beg for one piece of bread. Then the corporation was getting some helicopters and they were throwing all this food onto the terrace. That was the situation. All the money could not help them. In fact, some of them took the money and kept it also in a safer place, in a higher floor. But still, you cannot eat it. So, dhanyam, dhanya is Lakshmi. That is why we do not disrespect food. We do not step on it. And we always anna Lakshmi also we say, correct? Annam is Lakshmi. We treat annam with respect. It deserves. And you cannot waste it also. In fact, in the Taittiriya Upanishad, annanna parichakshita tadvratam. annanna parichakshita, do not waste food. This itself is a vratam. You can take it as a vrata, as a vow, and follow it sincerely. In fact, we used to have that in our dining hall. We took a printout and we pasted it in the dining hall. Annanna parichakshita tad vratam. So in the Gurukulam, when we were studying, the kitchen and the dining hall, we used to have this, do not waste food. In fact, that is why in our households, there is no concept of dinner conversation. When we were growing up, we never had any dinner conversation. In fact, if you talk while eating, it was considered to be something wrong because you are disrespecting the food. That's how we viewed it, at least when we were young. So you have to eat your food, focusing on the food itself. And you don't talk, so that that itself is considered as a disrespect to the Dhanya Lakshmi or Anna Lakshmi. So we have Dhanam, Dhanyam. Okay, food we have. Then what? There is also Gajalakshmi. So Gajalakshmi has two elephants by her side. Gajalakshmi means what? One who is, we can look at it in two, three ways, the Gajalakshmi. One who was worshipped by Gaja, by elephants, also you can take. Or one who is in the form of Gaja or animals. Because animals are very important part of our life even today. Some 100 years back, 150 years back, animals were very, very important, correct? Everything, the whole economy was based on animals. You had cows for giving milk. You had bulls and bullocks for drawing carts or even plowing the field. And animal like Gaja itself is important, correct? Kings had elephants as part of their army. In fact, Gajalakshmi can be even looked upon as the one who gives the kingdom itself. Because Gaja also is looked upon as a representative of a kingdom. So Gajalakshmi, you can look at it as animals, or you can look at it as a sign of a king. So that also is Lakshmi, Gajalakshmi. So Adi Lakshmi, Dhana Lakshmi, Dhanya Lakshmi, Gajalakshmi. Then what about family? All these things I have, but I don't have any children. That is a big problem for people. They go, nowadays you have all the, we hear even advertisements, that too in India. India is supposed to have a lot of population. But even here, we have all these advertisements for fertility clinics and all that. So nowadays, I think they even say that the food and all is all contaminated with pesticide. People are having problems reproducing, although our population is a lot. Still, there are lots of people who have issues in reproduction. So all these fertility clinics are having good business, in fact. They all advertise in the radio, even in the local Tamil FM radio, we hear advertisement for all these fertility clinics. Means that is problem now. You have everything, but no children. So children also are Lakshmi, correct? Santana Lakshmi. And that children also, they have to grow up well. That is a big problem. But still they are Lakshmi. We look upon our children also as Lakshmi, Santana Lakshmi. So that is also important, correct? Then what about your marriage, spouse, children we can go, but first marriage is important. Varalakshmi, spouse also is Lakshmi. Your marriage itself is a Lakshmi. That is the one which gives you security. Emotional security is very important. You can have all sorts of money, wealth, but if you are lonely, if you do not have anybody to share your emotions, to share your happiness, your sorrow, that becomes a problem. So Varalakshmi, so your marriage, your spouse also is Lakshmi for us. So Santana Lakshmi, Varalakshmi and all, we have to take it together. Okay. Then, okay, you have all these things, but you are always afraid. You have fear, you have phobia. Then you cannot enjoy any of this wealth, correct? So you require a certain mind, certain state of mind even to enjoy all this Lakshmi. So that is why the Dhairya Lakshmi also is there. Dhairya or Veera Lakshmi also we call. So Vara Lakshmi, Veera Lakshmi. Or Dhanam, Dhanyam, Dhairyam also. So Dhira means what? One who has discrimination also we can take. Okay, one who has certain intellectual capacity to discriminate and understand what is the truth is called a Dhira. But Dhira also can be the one who is courageous. So this courage and having a certain mind which can discriminate and understand things correctly, that also is a great wealth. Unless you have that, you cannot really even enjoy your wealth, correct? You should have a certain security, feeling of security, means you are, that's what is called courage in fact. Courage means, it doesn't mean you go and just beat up somebody on the road or something like that, understand it. That's not courage, that is stupidity. Courage means you are able to face whatever life may throw at you without really feeling down or anything, correct? Your ability to face different situations with a certain equanimity itself is courage. To understand what it takes in every situation and take the, do the right thing. These are all part of dhairyam, what we call dhairya. Unless you have that, all the other things which you may have in the form of Lakshmi may not be useful to you. So this Veera or Dhairya is very important. Then also Jayalakshmi or Vijayalakshmi. Whatever you do in life, some people are called unlucky. They are very talented. They have everything, but whatever they do, it becomes a failure. What do we do? Means that also you have to have, in fact, that is mostly a function of your own karma. But even then, whenever you take up an endeavor, the success you gain in that endeavor itself is a certain wealth, correct? We enjoy that a lot. Even you just plant a small sapling and when it becomes a tree and it is giving you some fruits, there is a certain ananda in that, correct? It's a great thing that we have tended for some plant over a period of time and then it has become successful now. It has come up. It is giving you the fruits. So any endeavor you take up, because there are so many slips between the cup and the lip, we say, correct? You may have something in the cup, but even taking it and drinking also sometimes is not easy. The cup may slip. So even anything we take up, if you want to have success in that, we have to have Ishvara with us. That's how we look at it, correct? In fact, our culture is very unique in that. That is something I acutely recognized when I went to US, actually. So when I first went to US, I was very impressed with all the infrastructure and all that. So first few weeks, you are just looking around. And then certain things strike you as how different it is. So in India, you get up in the morning, if you take a walk, then you hear all this, some suprabhatam. Even a shopkeeper, when they open the shop early in the morning, they are doing some aarti initially. There is an altar wherever you go. You get into a taxi, you have an altar in the taxi. So everything is started prayerfully. Even the names of the shops and all that will have the names of our devatas, correct? Or our deities. We even have wine shops like Venkatachalapathi wine shop. Even wine shops are called with the deity's name they have. That is how it is. So we are an incredibly religious people, prayerful in all our activities. Only in our cinema industry, a movie is always started with a puja, correct? Even Tamil Nadu, which is supposed to be all this Dravidian politics is there. Even here, whenever a movie is started in Tamil industry, they have a puja. It's not there in Hollywood, I think. They don't start a movie with a puja or anything. Maybe they'll have a kickoff party or some meeting. But it's not a puja. Even in Bombay also, it is the same thing. In Mumbai, North Indian film industry, Hindi film industry, any industry in India, forget the movie industry, because movie industry is highly success, failure. Nobody knows the formula. Once a movie is a hit, you can give 100 reasons for that. Or once a movie becomes a failure, you can again give a lot of reasons. After something happens, it is easy to find guna or dosha, correct? What went right, what is wrong. But while you are making it, it's not very easy. The success rate also is very less. That's why I think movie people are inherently, they understand so many factors which are not under their control. So then what we want to keep Ishvara as our partner. In fact, many companies in South India have Venkatachalapathi, Balaji, our Tirupati deity, as a shareholder. The first shareholder is Bhagwan. And every year they take that dividend and put it into the hundi. This practice is there among business people. Even, let us say, an industry like a steel industry. I used to work in Tata Steel in Jamshedpur. And we have this blast furnace where iron is made. And it keeps running for a few years. But you have to stop it once in a few years because the internal refractory lining and all, it wears out. So they have to rebuild the blast furnace again, and then they again start it. They burn. They fire the blast furnace again. So that firing is a very big ceremony. And when I was working, they called a pandit in Jamshedpur works. Especially, and then the pandit comes and does a puja before the firing of the blast furnace. Now, this can happen only in India. I don't think they do like that anywhere in US or Europe and all that. They don't call a priest and then they start it. That is because of our understanding that everything is Ishvara, correct? We want to have Ishvara, Bhagawan, as our partner. because we recognize, in spite of all my efforts, the results of action may not be like what I expect. It may not be successful. So the success itself we look upon as Lakshmi. That's why whatever endeavor we take up, the success also, karma phala data is Ishvara. Karma phala itself is Ishvara for us, not just the karma phala data. The one who gives the results of action is Bhagavan, but the results of action also is Bhagavan. Understand that. That is Lakshmi for us, whether it is success or failure, but we want it as success. So we look upon success as Vijaya Lakshmi, Jaya Lakshmi. And then what? Is there anything more? You have all this wealth, but again, wealth can buy certain things. You can buy a book if you are wealthy, but you cannot read and enjoy if you do not have a certain wisdom, knowledge to appreciate it, correct? So knowledge also is a great Lakshmi for us. So we have Vidya Lakshmi also. Although knowledge, again, we can look upon separately as Saraswati, but in the Ashtalakshmi, Vidya Lakshmi also is there in our tradition. So all the wealth you can have, but if you do not have the knowledge, the Vidya, in fact, the knowledge to handle wealth itself is a big thing, correct? Everybody cannot handle wealth. You can have a lot of wealth, but you should be knowledgeable enough to first protect it. See, we call yoga kshemam. Two words are there. In Bhagavad Gita also, Bhagavan says, yoga kshemam vahamyaham. So ananyas chintayanto mam ye janah paryupasate tesham nityabhiyuktanam yogakshemam vahamyaham. Yogakshemam vahamyaham is the slogan of LIC also in India. Life Insurance Corporation has taken this Bhagavad Gita verse. In fact, in India, many of our public institutions and all have that. Even our Air Force has taken Nabhas Prishtam Deeptam Anekam, like that. There is a, in the 11th chapter, verses there. They are taken from Bhagavad Gita. LIC has taken from Bhagavad Gita. Even Satyameva Jayate is from Upanishad. Okay. Vasudeva Kutumbakam and all they say. Udarat Charitanam Vasudeva Kutumbakam, like that it is there. That is talking actually about a jnani. There is a Mahopanishad. So that is from the Upanishad again. Like this, all these famous even brands which have their own some slogan. That is all from our Upanishads and Gita. Anyway, so the yoga means to actually gain something. Yoga means, yuj means getting connected, getting associated with also. There is a meaning means, you know, whenever you get something, you are connected with that, correct? You are coming in, you are joining with that essentially. So yoga means to attain something, to accrue something, to accumulate something. In this case, generally yoga means the ability to earn, or when you earn wealth, it is yoga, fine. But then next day you go to Las Vegas and spend everything, gamble away, means there is no kshema. Kshema means what? Ability to protect that wealth. It's not only that you gain wealth, you should be able to protect it. Nowadays, protect means what? You have to invest. You have to take care of inflation. You have to grow. And that's how you protect also. Now, all this requires a lot of knowledge. You may get wealth, you may get wealth even from lottery, but if you don't know how to handle the wealth, if you don't have that knowledge, that becomes a problem. That is why Vidya Lakshmi is very important. Vidya is important. So Ashta Lakshmi is how we look upon Lakshmi. Lakshmi is not just one thing for us. In fact, whatever you want to attain in life, all of them we look upon as some devata, some deity. Lakshmi, Saraswati only will cover everything. In fact, we are all the time going after Lakshmi and Saraswati in our life. So our day-to-day pursuits are not separate from Bhagavan, because Bhagavan only is manifest as all these things. Whatever we pursue is not separate from Bhagavan. Bhagavan only is manifest as all these things. So that is our vision, great vision, correct? So that is where the devata we have to understand. Shri is a devata. Shri is wealth. Again, wealth only we look upon in an eightfold manner like this. And then, so we say that Bhagavan is manifest as the Shri Devata. And then we can pray to that Devata, correct? Specific prayer for wealth we can do to the Shri as a Devata. So that's what all these suktas. We can have sukta. There is also Go Sukta is there, because Go also, cattle was looked upon as a form of wealth. Okay. So like this, different types of phenomenon, when we look at it in totality, we say that it is a manifestation of Bhagavan. And then we have a Adhishtana Devata with reference to that. That's why we have 33 crore devatas, we say, correct? 33 crore means what? 330 million devatas are there. In fact, in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, there is a particular chapter there, or a section, where initially there is a question, how many devatas are there? So Yajnavalkya then gives a big number, some thousands of devatas are there. Then again, how many devatas are there? He reduces it. He keeps on naming also all these different devatas. And finally, he says there is only one devata, which is Prana Devata, like that. Prana there is for Saguna Brahmanam, Brahman. So only one devata is there really, who is the totality of everything. But then again, that one devata can be looked upon like we have one body, but many parts are there, correct, in our body itself. So overall one devata, but again that devata's body itself can have many parts, and each part, each indriya of the totality also is a devata in totality if you look at it. So that is how it is. That is why we have all these devatas, and we can have so many prayers addressed to all these devatas. So here we have this beautiful Sukta called Shri Sukta, which we chant regularly in our temples. It's a very popular chant, and actually it is part of the Rig Veda. So in Rig Veda, there is a Khila Bhaga, we say. Khila Bhaga means Khila are like appendix to the Veda. So the Shri Sukta is part of the fifth mandala. The Rig Veda itself is divided into many mandalas. So the Khila Bhaga of the fifth mandala, the Shri Sukta is there. So it is a from the Rig Veda. That is why today the Shanti Mantra I chanted from Rig Veda. Vangme Manasi Pratishthita is a Shanti Mantra from the Rig Veda. Normally we chant that. So depending on the Veda, we can chant different Shanti mantras. So if it is Krishna Yajurveda, we normally chant Sahana Vavatu or Shanno Mitrasyam Varunaha. If it is Shukla Yajurveda, we chant Purnamadav Purnamidam. If it is Atharvana Veda, we can chant this Badram Karnebhi Shrinuyama Devaha. Like that, Rigveda, many Shanti mantras are there. Whatever I know, only I can chant. So we generally chant Vang Me Manasi Pratishthita. That is the Shanti mantra here. And then there are 15 rigs are there in this Shri Sukta. Whatever we call as Shri Sukta, there are 15 rigs, because Rigveda means all rigs are there. Rig means a mantra which is set to a certain meter. It is all verse. Correct? There is a chandas for that. Then it is called a rig or rich. Rigveda. Then there is a Phalashruti also is there. The 16th itself is a Phalashruti actually. And then there are 11 more also we normally chant. Or 11 or few more are there actually, because different variation readings are all there. This part is also called Lakshmi Sukta sometimes. Whatever we chant after the Shri Sukta, after the 16th one, whatever we chant, 11 more we chant many times. Thus, that part can also be called as Lakshmi Sukta. Now, in this, whenever we chant all this Sukta, we are supposed to do Nyasam, we say, because you have to always remember the Rishi, Chandas and the Devata. And then there are some more also you can do. This Bijam, Kilakam, Shakti and all that also when we do some Mantra Japa and all. We have all those. What is the, for a particular mantra, there is a Bija, there is a seed from which it has come. Like that we look upon. So like this, here also, traditionally, that means we should know who is the Rishi for this Shri Sukta. In fact, in some cases, there can be more than one Rishi also. Not just one Rishi, but we can have many Rishis. So in this case, who is the Rishi? Means there are four Rishis are there, not just one Rishi. Okay. Sri Sukta has four Rishis. There is a Shrida, like that there is a Rishi. Shrida Rishi, Ananda Rishi, Kardama Rishi and Chiklita. Okay. So these are the four Rishis. And in fact, they are considered to be the children of Shri herself or even Parameshwara, Indra Suta, like that also, Rishayaha, we say. So there are four Rishis for this Shri Sukta. And then the Chandas. What are all the Chandas here? More than one Chandas is there because there are 15 rigs are there, correct? So since 15 rigs are there, the most popular Chandas in the Veda, if you take, is Anushtup. Then Gayatri, all these Chandas are also there. But Anushtup is also very popular in classical Sanskrit, correct? Even after the Vaidika literature, whatever is there. You have Ramayana, you have Mahabharata, you have the other Puranas. Everywhere, the Anushtup Chandas is very, very prevalent. Anushtup Chandas means what? It has 32 matras, 32 syllables. arranged in four padas, four quarters. Each quarter, each pada having eight matras, eight syllables. There are further rules also are also there in Chandas, in Prasadi, that where a hraswa has to be there, where a dirgha or a guru, they call it. Okay, laghu guru, like that they call the syllable, because it's not always dirgha. Even a conjunct consonant is considered to be a guru. So where you should have laghu, where you should have guru, like that rules are there for Chandas. So Anushtup Chandas, here the first three you can see are Anushtup, and then the fourth and fifth are bigger, you can see here, correct? So it is not Anushtup. So what are the fourth and fifth, or first to four? Fourth itself is very different, correct? Kam so smitam hiranya prakara madran jvalantim triptan tarpayantim. So it has extended a little bit here. Then it looks like again 8, 8, 8. Then 12 is there. One pada is 12 matra. It is bigger. Okay. That is means total 36 matras are there here. This is called Brihati Chandas. The fourth one is Brihati, because it has 36. The 36 also is not arranged 9, 9, 9, 9. No. 8, 12, 8, 8. You can see the arrangement here, correct? 8, 12, then 8 and 8. This is Brihati Chandas. Then 5 and 6 are much bigger, correct? It's bigger than 36 also. This is called Trishtup Chandas. 44 are there here. 11 each in every pada. 44. Trishtup also is a very popular meter. Even in Bhagavad Gita, wherever Bhagavan Vyasa wants to show some difference, suddenly he'll change the meter also. Okay, something important. Even the 15th chapter and all starts with this Trishtup Chandas, correct? Urdhva Mulam Adashakam Ashwattam Prahur Arvayam Avyayam Chantam Siyasya Parnani Yastam Vedasa Vedavithu. That is Anushtup, but then Adaschordvam Prasitastasya Shakaha Guna Pravruddha Vishaya Pravalaha. Like that, it becomes Trishtup. Even the almost the entire 11th chapter also, lot of verses are in Trishtup, because Bhagavan Vyasa, when he was showing the, Bhagavan was showing the Vishwarupa, Vyasa changes the Chandas also. It becomes Trishtup Chandas. So Trishtup means 44 matras are there, 11 each in every pada, every quarter. That is Trishtup. So 5 and 6 are also Trishtup. Again, it goes, all looks like all Anushtup only, correct? Except for 15th alone is different. So 1 to 3 is Anushtup. 4 is Brihati. 5, 6 is Trishtup. 15th is called, it's a Pankti, Prastara Pankti, they say. Pankti is also another Chandas. Has 40 matras, but this 40 is not equally divided into 10 each. No. 8, 8, 12, 8. That is how it is. That is called Prastara Pankti. 8, 8, 12, 8. No, no, sorry. 8, 8, 12, 12. That becomes 40. 8, 8, 12, 8 is like Brihati. So you can see here, 8, 8, 12, 12. That is Prastara Pankti, 40. It has to have 40 matras. So like this, these four chandas, four rishis are there, four chandas are, chandas also is there, four different chandas or meters in this Sri Sukta. Then who is the devata? Devata is Shri only. Shri Devata or Lakshmi is the Devata. And then in the Nyasa, we also do something called Viniyoga. What is the usage of this Sukta? Means Japa, you can do Japa, regular chanting, correct? Or Shri Suktam also Homa, Homa Karma also we can do. You can use it based on Shri Sukta, they do Homa. Means in the Homa again, you have to chant so many times and then do Swaha every time. You have to offer something into the fire. Shri Sukta Homa also is popular. Many people do that. Then there is a Phalashruti. 16th is Phalashruti and then there are 11 more I told you. Correct. So like this, Shri Suktam is a very popular Suktam. We chant this Sukta. It is essentially a prayer to Lakshmi. So we, in fact, the first rig itself is very interesting. We tell Agni that, hey Agni, Jataveda, that's how it starts, correct? Jatavedaha is there here also. So Jataveda is the name of Agni. Even in Durga Suktam we saw, correct? Jataveda se sunavama soma marati yato nidavati vedaha, like that. Jataveda means what? Jataha, Vedaha, Yasmat, from whom all knowledge is born, Agni. Because Agni is bright. Agni represents knowledge. Agni represents consciousness. In fact, all knowledge we say is Hiranyagarbha. Because first there is all knowledge, then only the Srishti. And Bhagavan visualizes this all knowledge and becomes manifest as this Srishti. That is how we understand Srishti or creation. So all knowledge here is Hiranyagarbha really, but Agni also is a representation of Hiranyagarbha here. So Agni, you can take this Jataveda as Agni Devata, because Agni is the postman for all devatas, correct? Because you may offer an ahuti or an offering to any devata, but you offer it only to Agni. So here we can take that we are asking Agni, Avaha, you invite, you bring whom? Whom are you inviting? Whom do you want Agni to bring? Hiranyavarnam. One who is golden colored, shining like gold. Okay. Hiranya Varnam. Iva Varnaha Yasya. Yasyaha, we have to say feminine. So the one whose color is like gold, shining like that. In fact, the color also is given here. Harini. Harini means Hari can mean green also, but here we have to take it more like yellow. Yellow is green or yellow is better color because it goes along with gold. Right? Golden, yellow, one who is shining like gold and one who is slightly yellowish or yellowish green we can take in that color. And how is this Devata whom we want Agni to bring to us? She is wearing Suvarna Rajatasraja. She is wearing a mala made up of Suvarna and Rajata. The flowers are all golden and silver, it seems. Or Suvarna and Rajata can also mean sun and moon. She is wearing sun and moon or stars as her garland. That way also we can take. Or Suvarna Rajata also you can take. The silver which is having good color. But anyway, being the Devata of wealth, what do you expect? Lakshmi Devi will not be wearing a Rudraksha mala. She is wearing a mala of golden silver flowers you can take. And she is like the moon, pleasant. And she is Lakshmi also. She represents all wealth. She is Hiranmayi. So, this is the Devata whom we want with us. Why? All that we'll see next week. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.
धन्यवाद.